Here's a reminder to stay out of trouble in the small blind. Unless you can enter the pot cheaply against non-aggressive opponents, you might put giant holes in your bankroll when playing the small blind. The problem with the small blind is that you're guaranteed to have the worst position, meaning you'll have to act first on the flop and beyond. Despite this, you should be very aggressive in the small blind if the big blind folds too often. Big blinds should usually be defended against small raises from late positions, and opponents who surrender too often make it profitable for you to take a shot from the small blind. By surrendering too often, we mean that an opponent will fold about a quarter of the time or more. That means at least one in four times you'll win both the big blind and your small blind immediately, and the rest of the time you'll compete often at a slight advantage or a small disadvantage. Overall, you earn money by attacking big blinds who fold a lot. So remember, consider raising liberally from the small blind seat if the big blind folds too often.
Doyle, you say a lot about superstition. I kind of have never been involved in having any myself, but I'd certainly be open to having some that work if you want to give them to me. Tell me about superstitions.
I don't really believe in superstition, Mike.
Oh, you're my man.
I observe some of them simply because it doesn't cost you anything to observe them. You know, maybe there's a reason you shouldn't walk under a ladder. Maybe a ladder's going to fall on you.
So well, that's true.